version 1 is better than version 1. And I, or rather, the speaker was the version 1. Good morning, one and all, and Toastmaster Anitha in particular. What a beautiful icebreaker you have given. An icebreaker, a speech that in which you had to not just introduce yourself, but you also had an important message for every single one of us. A catchy start to start off with, where you had humor, which grabbed everyone's attention, and then you conveyed your message at the very first point. You hit the nail when you had the attention, and bam, you were on the target. However, that was not your actual start. You came up on the stage, you said, you addressed the team only, thank you Toastmasters, now I'm gonna start. So that's not the way any speaker should start a speech, because the first verbal or non-verbal gesture that you make starts your speech. So you had a good start, but you improvised, so that didn't work as a speaker. However, as I said, a catchy start. Then you moved on with your story. Another good aspect that I liked about your speech was the way you have crafted your speech. The way you told your story about how you were being bullied, how you played cricket with your siblings, cricket, football, and the description that you had, taking out ball from nannies and everything. So that was brilliantly done. So you all could imagine as to what exactly is been happening there. Brilliantly done. Also, what I noticed was, you didn't just have description about yourself, you were even describing every single person who was coming on the stage. For example, the person whom you played cricket with, or the girl whom you were jealous with because she was the one who would always stop her. So you didn't just have introduction or something about the history of yourself, but about the speaker as well. This is a brilliant art when it comes to storytelling. However, this would exactly not fit in to your icebreaker. Your icebreaker is something in which you are introducing yourself, not the people around you in that brilliant way. So you introduce everyone in good way except for yourself. That was one point where you could have reduced your content for others except for you. One good thing that I liked, as I said earlier, was your speech had various instances of humor. It was in the beginning, it was in the middle. So humor was there at times when it was needed so that audience, you don't lose the audience. Brilliantly done. Also, as the previous evaluator just mentioned about the pendulum effect, I noticed you have a twisted angle to that because your pendulum was of this sort. You kept on moving on this stage to and fro again and again, and not the entire stage as a whole. Yes, it's an icebreaker, but it's a pathways icebreaker. So all the points that we speak of, your eye contact, your hand gesture, everything would come into picture. So that's where I feel you could challenge yourself. Not your weaknesses, but things that you could challenge yourself. Other than that, a slight introduction as about your college or what exactly do you want to do in your future, or why did you choose this path in the first place, or something of that sort to connect with this path could have been done. So the way you told your story, the way you started your story, the way you described your childhood life, the way you told as to how Toastmasters kicked in, everything was done. A couple of things were missing because you had focused more on other things. So yes, you have broken the ice. Just make sure that in the end, it's about telling yourself, because here we would like to know about you rather than everyone else. So a brilliant job done. I would love to see your future speeches again. All the very best. Bye.